حابة أكمل لآخر يوم.
Protest and a peaceful demonstration by the fence between Israel and Gaza. An Israeli sniper looked across the fence, saw a young Palestinian, a 20 years old Razan al-Najjar. She is a medic who was trying to save a life. The Israeli sniper looked, aimed, thought, and shot and killed Razan al-Najjar. She has become the symbol of the fate of the Palestinian inside the besieged Gaza. Nadar al-Najjar, who is she? What is her story? Our guest today, Khalil Abu Yahya. He is an activist living in Gaza. He is also a research in culture and monitoring the situation there in Gaza. Welcome to Bilahdan, Khalil. Can you tell us a little bit about Razan al-Najjar and what she is symbolizing now for the Palestinian people?
Okay, Razan al-Najjar, my friend, represents every Palestinian here in Gaza who is resisting against the will of the occupier and against the humiliating conditions we are living in Gaza. We want a change, and we want our basic rights to be implemented. We want the United Nations Resolution 194 to be implemented. We want our rights to be on the ground, and that's why the people are after what I have mentioned about the aspects of life in Gaza. People wanted to refuse those things, to refuse the humiliation, to refuse the occupation and apartheid. And that's why we are showing you forms of resistance. Negotiations have failed us. Arab leaders have failed us also. In the military equation, we and Israel, we are not equal to equal parties, because Israel has the fourth strongest army in the world, and that's why we wanted to go to a popular resistance in all its form. I think it is accumulative, my friend. In 2005 to 2004, the Palestinian civil society launched a call calling for the international community to boycott Israel, divest from it, and impose sanctions against Israel. It complies with international law and until it respects the Palestinian basic rights at least. And then it is culminated by the Great March of Return. And history, we know that history teaches us a lot. Razan knew that history teaches from 1948. It has not been against us physically, but also it is against our narratives. It is killing our narrative. And our houses, which were demolished and bombed by Israel F-16s. We are not allowed to work peacefully. We are not allowed or to farm, because Israel would shoot us. We are not allowed to sleep peacefully one night without being disturbed by Israeli attacks and Israel F-16s. We have no access to our rights. 2 million Palestinians who are living in Gaza are denied from their basic human rights, which are guaranteed under the international law. When we walk in the street, we know very well that we may be the target of Israel snipers and soldiers, and especially the young people. For Israel, the younger, the better to be killed. Our dreams are forbidden. Our hopes are being fought. Israel dehumanizes us because we were not born to Jewish mothers. We are Israel subjects us to genocidal wars. Genocidal wars, why? Because we are the goyim, the other, and for Israel, we don't deserve our rights. We are living in subhuman conditions. And this is, my friend, the tip of the iceberg. This is the tip of the iceberg. Gaza, the siege on Gaza has been described by Richard Falk, the former UN special rapporteur to the occupied Palestinian territory. He described it as a prelude to genocide. And then a leading human rights organization in Israel, Beit Salem, and an Israel historian, Ilan Babi, called it slow motion genocide. And then many organizations called Gaza the most concentration camp on earth, and then an open inner prison, even bigger than Auschwitz and Warsaw. This is Gaza, and for this we are at the end of the day we are being blamed for our suffering and our oppression. Israel has been adopting what every settler colonial system and apartheid system has been adopting, which is victims blaming. I remember when I read about the defunct apartheid system in South Africa in the 60s and 70s, they adopted the victims of blaming, and this is what Israel are doing, and this is why the people of Gaza want to tell the international community that we are fed up and that enough is enough, and we need from you to show us common humanity, people to people solidarity, because the silence of the international community means complicity, nothing else, means complicity, and this is something must be broken. This in a brief.
In America here, we are being focused on ISIS and beheading and all this tragedy committed by ISIS, the Islamic State, but we are not focusing on the crime and genocide and beheading Gaza from the Jewish state. So, but tell us a little bit about the role that Arab leaders are taking in this tragedy.
That the complicity of the Arab leaders and they being normalizing with apartheid Israel is one of the major reasons why we are still suffering. This normalization and showing Israel as a good state, as a state for all of its citizens and servicing Israeli propaganda and Hasbara to show it as a friend or as a human rights defender and all of these things, that things are against us because nothing is implemented on the ground from what they are claiming that Israel defend their rights. Which rights? Israel define itself as a state for Jewish people and Jewish only. And this is something racist. And we still, after the killing of Razan al-Najjar, a medic, and after the killing of Layla, 8 months baby, and after the killing of all these people, they are still normalizing. They are still showing Israel that it is something normal for Israel to occupy us.
Khalil Abu Yahya, an activist and a research and cultural study, lives in Gaza, and he reflects on life in Gaza and this massacre and genocide has been taken, it's been for years, especially in the last weeks. And thank you so much, Khalil. We wish you well and keeping this voice heard. And as you said, people without voice are not people, and I think we heard you, loud and clear. And we wish you well, and thank you so much for spending some time with us.
You are welcome. You are welcome. Thank you.
يعود يرفي السهر يعود متكي على المخمل تتوجع وبتروح آخر دني وترجع تكتب وتمحي حدود يا عود قصورك الأرخام والنوافير وتشعشع الكاسات عخصور تتلوى وحرير يطير حيران ما بتنام وصوتك يطير